Hi everyone, welcome back. We're going to be doing a partial fractions integral. This problem is the integral of 5 over 2x plus 1 times x minus 2 dx. Okay, so this, even if it were not in a partial fractions section of the book, this problem would stick out to us as a partial fractions problem because of the obvious way that the denominator is separated into these two terms, 2x plus 1 and x minus 2. That makes it really easy to turn this into a partial fractions problem. So the way that we do partial fractions, we ignore the integral for now, and we write this whole thing again. 5 over 2x plus 1 times x minus 2. And we set that equal to a, plus b. A and b over one of each of these terms. So you can randomly assign them, it doesn't matter. You could flip this order if you wanted. 2x plus 1 and x minus 2. But the point is, you put a over one of the terms, and b over another term. You always add in the center here, and you just write this whole thing out. So this is the first step always in partial fractions. This is your original problem, and this is a over one term and b over the other. So now that you've written this out, what you want to go ahead and do is multiply each of these terms by the whole denominator here. So this is going to be multiplied by 2x plus 1 times x minus 2, and then same thing with a, 2x plus 1 times x minus 2, and same thing with b, 2x plus 1, x minus 2, right? So you multiply each of these terms by the denominator, and obviously what you may see that that's leading to is that we're going to be canceling terms. So since this is on the top here, right, 2x plus 1 is going to cancel, and x minus 2 is going to cancel, and we'll be left with just 5 on this side. So 5 equals. Then 2x plus 1 is going to cancel here, so we're left with a times x minus 2 plus, and then x minus 2 is going to cancel here, so we're left with b times 2x plus 1. So as you can see, you probably could have just gone straight from this, from the original problem to this step without doing this step and skipping it. Basically, you just have the numerator here, 5, and then a times one of the terms in the denominator plus b times another term. But I just went through this step so that you could see how we get here. So once we get to this point, a lot of professors will tell you how to do this in kind of a fancier way, but really, I think the easiest way to do it, what you need to do is solve this equation for a and b. And the simplest way to do that, and it works every time, is just to plug in the number for x that will turn this term into zero and that will turn this term into zero. So let's just, I'll show you what I mean. That wasn't a very good explanation, but we're going to make this a zero, so and that'll cancel one of a or b out. So, for example, x minus 2. To make that zero, we have to plug in 2 for x, right? 2 minus 2 is zero. So if we plug in 2 for x, then this goes away and becomes zero, right? Zero, which means that a cancels out because we've got a times zero, so a goes away. So what we're left with is 5 equals b times 2x plus 1. And of course we plugged in 2 for x, so this is actually 2 here. We have to plug in 2 for x. So we're left with 5 equals b times 2 times 2 is 4 plus 1 is 5. So 5b equals 5, b equals 1, right? So we solved for b. We got b equals 1. Let's go ahead and leave that down here. Then, let me go ahead and rewrite this so that you can see. A times x minus 2 Now, we want to set this whole term equal to 0. So, 2x plus 1, and you can just do it this way too. 2x plus 1 equals 0. If it's more complicated than this, obviously plugging 2 in for x here makes this 0. This is a tiny bit more complicated. So you can just set it equal to 0. You say 2x equals negative 1 when you subtract 1 from both sides, and then you get x equals negative 1 half. So x is negative 1 half. If you plug in negative 1 half to here, this whole term will go away. And if you plug in negative 1 half here, you get negative 5 halves, right? So you end up with 5 equals a times negative 5 halves. You multiply both sides by 2. You get 10 equals a times negative 5. 10 divided by negative 5 is negative 2. So a equals negative 2. So that's how, I think that's the easiest way to solve for a and b. You've got a equals negative 2 and b equals 1. So now that we've done that, you're going to take a and b and plug them back into this part of the equation right here. So you'll have negative 2 over 2x plus 1 plus 1 over x minus 2, and you put that back into the integral. So let's go ahead and erase all this so that I have some room, and I'll erase this. I just don't want to forget what my a and b are. So we're going to have the integral, a is negative 2, of negative 2 over 2x plus 1 plus, and then b is 1, 1 over x minus 2. So plus 1 over x minus 2. So we solve for a and b, we plug them into that the right side of that first equation. Don't forget to add dx because it's proper notation whenever you have an integral. And so now this is actually something we can take the integral of. And partial fraction problems almost always end in the same way, where you have a simple number, negative 2 or 1, in the numerators, and then one of the terms here in the denominator. So the most important formula that we need to remember here is that the integral of 1 over x is equal to natural log, or ln, of the absolute value of x. Because, as you can see, when we take the integral of this, we'll take it one term at a time. This negative 2 over 2x plus 1 is going to turn into negative 2 times ln of the absolute value of 2x plus 1. So you can see you put the denominator into the absolute value here. So 2x plus 1 came for the denominator here. And whatever we had in the numerator just gets multiplied out in front here. So negative 2 times ln of the absolute value of 2x plus 1, and then ln the absolute value of x minus 2. So you can see how we broke those two terms apart. Don't forget to add c to account for the constant. Our 1 here is out in front, right? But it's implied, so we don't need to have it. We do obviously need to have the negative 2 that came from here. So this could be your final answer. Technically, it's correct, but we can simplify this. I'm actually going to flip the terms around. I'm going to bring this one out in front here. Ln of the absolute value of x minus 2 minus 2 ln of the absolute value of 2x plus 1. And this you can actually simplify. When you have natural log of one value minus natural log of another value, you can simplify them by turning them into a fraction. So this actually ends up being ln of the absolute value of x minus 2 over the absolute value of 2x plus 1. Because, like I said, when you have natural log of one thing minus natural log of the second thing. The first thing goes on the top, second thing goes on the bottom. And I'm just realizing you may have wondered why I didn't account for the negative 2 here. When we took the integral of this first term here, natural log of 2x plus 1, you have to use chain rule to take the integral of the inside. So what happens here, because this right here is more complicated than just x, you always have to remember to divide by the derivative of the inside. So the derivative of 2x plus 1 is just 2. This 1 goes away, the derivative of 2x is 2. So you have to divide here by 2. Here, we would apply the same thing, but the derivative of the inside here is just 1. So you end up dividing the whole thing by 1, which you don't have to write. But when I divide this by 2, see the 2's cancel, and you end up with just a negative. So that 2 actually goes away, and you're left with ln of the absolute value of x minus 2 minus ln of the absolute value of 2x plus 1, which is why I didn't include anything about this 2 here, because I actually should have canceled it in a previous step. So I'm sorry for that being a little bit confusing. But since there's no coefficients here and this is completely clean, this is your final answer, except always don't forget to add C to account for that constant. So that's your final answer, and I'll see you guys in the next problem.